If you do like these tank chats, do please subscribe to the Tank Museum's YouTube channel.
Now we're going to look at the Wheel-cum-Track machine. Now it's quite unusual. For some reason, the experts have it down as an armoured car. In all the old publications, it's referred to as an armoured car, except in the Tank Museum's own publication, where it suddenly becomes a tank. Take your pick. It runs on wheels and tracks, at least that's the theory, but it's unusual in that the tracks are the things that go up and down. The wheels stay where they are, which is why you're looking at the front wheels here. The bracket that holds them is sort of riveted to the front of the vehicle. There's a big leaf spring running transversely, and there are the wheels. They're solid rubber. They're actually fitted with a type of tyre known as the natural air pressure tyre. And those triangular bits in it are the pockets that trap the air. The idea is that as you're going along, they provide the cushion that you'd normally get from a pneumatic tyre. What actually happens is half the time they fill with mud. By that time, then, of course, it's just a solid rubber tyre, but there you are. That's like what they did. They do wear better than pneumatics, but they also give a very harsh ride. And that's what this one is. Now, the rear wheels you can't see so easily. They're set in a sort of recess in the back of the vehicle. They're the driven wheels. They're fitted with the same sort of tyres, and they're all hidden by the mechanism that makes the tracks go up and down. And it would do it about 25 miles an hour on its wheels, and probably about 10, 13 miles an hour on tracks, that was all. Now the tracks you'll see are on a framework fitted to the side of the vehicle. They move up and down on rails on the side of the vehicle. And when you go up close and have a look at them, they don't appear to have any sprung suspension at all. They do move, each wheel's on a sort of a bracket arrangement. And I think they work rather like the American light tanks, the early ones. They adjust to the ground and they adjust to one another, but they're not really sprung, not in the proper sense. So they give an even harsher ride on the odd occasions when you use them. The tracks are powered. They work on a swing arm basis to go up and down, driven by the motor. The vehicle is powered by a 90 horsepower V8 Armstrong Siddeley. It's the air-cooled engine. It's the same engine you'll find in the medium tanks. And that's located here in the front with the driver alongside it. It's a most peculiar system because that engine not only governs the movement of the tracks going up and down, it's also, and you can select these on a lever, it has two other options. One of them is to drive the wheels, which it does through the differential at the back. The other thing is to drive the tracks, which it does when the tracks are on the ground. And you have to select which one you want each time. On tracks, the vehicle has an incredibly short track base, actually almost within the wheel layout of the thing. And therefore, it must rock quite heavily. But they didn't seem to worry about that, at least if they did. They didn't know it was going to do it till they built it. Well, three of these altogether. Two of them were built by Vickers Armstrong. This is the, in 1928, this is the first one, and it's fitted with two turrets, as you can see. The main turret up there has a space for two machine guns that fitted in. They never were mounted, it was only ever an experimental vehicle. And there's another rotating turret on a lower level at the back with one machine gun in it, or at least it should have. And that means the vehicle's complicated anyway. But they built another one which was more or less the same to look at, except it didn't have the superstructure at all. Behind the driver's position was just a big open tray. We don't know what it was intended for, but one was built and tested and scrapped. This one, as you can see, has survived. The third one was very odd. It was built without tracks at all and sold as an armoured car to the Hungarian police. What they wanted it for, Lord alone knows. It ran on solid tyres. It must have been a swine to drive in normal circumstances, but there we are. That's what happened to the third one of these vehicles. And you do see odd photos of it now and again in Hungarian service, which is quite an unusual arrangement. But that's the basic vehicle for you. It's covered in armour, well, it's not really armoured at the moment, it's mild steel, but it represents armour 8 millimetres thick, which is the same thickness as you'll find on a Rolls-Royce armoured car. So although it's quite, it's bulletproof up to a point, it's not really very substantial and is easily knocked out by a tank. But whether it really was a tank or an armoured car, nobody knows. It's just one of those oddities. But really the whole wheel and track concept is idiotic. It means that you've got to select what you, the conditions you want for the ground you're going over. And you can either have a wheeled vehicle running at reasonably high speed or a tracked vehicle running very slowly. That's usual with these things. But horrible thing to drive, and even worse to actually operate in any sense. Very uncomfortable, I would think.
If you like these films, please do subscribe to the Tank Museum's YouTube channel, and if you can, please do support us on Patreon.